Hi everyone, Euthany S. Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for a review of the new US Girls album, In a Poem Unlimited. Megan Remy, aka US Girls, sixth album over here, latest for 4AD Records. She's been at it for a while now, plugging away under this name for over 10 years, so why am I formally reviewing her music now? US Girls is something that I've been familiar with in a cursory way for a little bit now. I did cover the project's last full-length album in a 2015 Why You Know review. And while Megan's music under this name has been an interesting blend of psychedelic, lo-fi, experimental art pop, for me some of the songs and the character of the music wasn't really translating, which is not an issue at all with Unlimited over here because this is easily US Girls' catchiest album yet. Nearly every US Girls album so far has been kind of noisy and rough around the edges to some degree, but Unlimited over here is so much more well-assembled and cleaner than all of its predecessors. But as Megan has refined the sound quality of US Girls on this album, her style under the name has only grown more diverse. Because this album is pretty versatile and completely pulls US Girls out of the dregs of lo-fi music. Across this LP, you're gonna catch whiffs of synth pop and art pop and disco and kind of rootsy, dusty blues rock. Soul, dream pop, baroque pop too. And rarely are you hearing any of these elements merely by themselves on this album. They're fused in a way where they blend pretty seamlessly, which is easily one of the most creative things about this record. That and how consistently infectious and thoughtful these songs are. From the hooks to the lyrics on this thing, there are actually a lot of layers to Unlimited. I could be wrong, but the song Velvet for Sale seems to be about violence, vengeance, and gender politics. M-A-H, or Mad as Hell. Wrong me, wrong. I said the wrong thing. The song's actually about President Obama. And the sentiment of the track, I can actually identify with pretty deeply, considering how frustrated I am with just the lack of any progress on much of anything under the Obama administration generally. Oh, except foreign interventions. We increased those. We did more of those, and the drone strikes. We were really good at doing more of that. Rage of Plastics also seems to be about a relationship of some sort, but one where she ends up leaving because she needs to move on because it's potentially just a really weird dynamic. Older man, wants a kid. She ends up working at a refinery of some sort, or at least the protagonist in her story. I also love the play on words on the song L Over, or Lover. The letter portion of the song where she's kind of spelling the word out is pretty smart as well. While the song Poem to me sends out a message of unity and equality and advocates for the idea of a system where everybody can kind of succeed or not worry about being ground into the gears of society. Personally, while I do prefer things to be a bit more competitive and meritocratic, I do appreciate the sentiment of the track and kind of agree, because truth be told, I don't really believe in the idea of putting lives on the line just so that we can make our healthcare system for profit. One of the many changes of pace I'm sure Megan is enjoying since she recently moved to Canada. You know, not dying due to lack of healthcare or going bankrupt, that sort of thing. While the song topics on this record are very nice, what I'm mostly enamored with is just the sound of these songs. The production is incredible and all over the place stylistically. And even as these tracks veer into one genre after another genre after another genre, the beats, the instrumentation never really seem to falter. It's all really well put together. I love the slow, plodding, and psychedelic instrumental that kicks the album off on Velvet for Sale. The funky and endless grooves that close the album out on the song Time. Very sharp, very visceral, but maybe not as sharp and visceral as the incredibly peppy disco that lands on the track Mad as Hell, which has some musical passages in it that reads like they're coming out of a Blondie album. The very rough blues rock sound on the track Rage of Plastics is pretty nice too. The song Rosebud has an instrumental that is a bit of a very lavish, dreamy pop music. Something I could see a Julia Holter fan getting into, but there's also like a cycling, very groovy beat on the song too. It seems like she's almost paying an homage to 90 pop aesthetics. One thing about the 90s that I feel like a lot of people forget, which Megan most likely remembers being around my age, there were these amazing fusions of funk and soul and pop and rock and hip-hop in the mainstream topping the charts. There were just so many artists and there were just so many bands trying to put together everything all at once musically and just getting it to work pretty well. Something I also think shines through on the track Pearly Gates. Not only is this like the best song on on here, but I love the chilling vocal harmonies. I love the little lead melodies. The groove is killer. You have like some turntables in here somewhere too. So it's a little bit of a hip hop and pop rock blend, and you cannot tell me that the singing on the chorus of this thing, it sounds like frickin' Nate Dogg. Rest in peace to Nate Dogg. The things that I don't care on this record for generally are that it's a little bit of a mess as far as the flow. It's very tight because each song is very catchy, but it just kind of feels like a mixed bag at the end of the day. And while I would say that something like Megan's voice is kind of the thread that pulls the entire thing together, Megan herself vocally is a little bit of a chameleon. She definitely changes her inflection and her tone to fit whatever instrumental she's on top of. Sometimes she has the delivery of an old alt-country songstress. Other times she's got this high-pitched, wailing, almost baby voice timbre that reads to me as being like Cyndi Lauper. The guy editing this video said to me it reminded him a little bit of Gwen Stefani, which I kind of agree with to an extent. And again, Megan is not always embodying or kind of giving off the vibes of any one singer on this album. It's really just a lot. And I guess I'll also say that while I do enjoy a lot of the instrumentation on the track Poem, I don't really care for the vocal processing on the track at all. It kind of buries Megan's voice and makes them feel a little robotic and distant and difficult to connect with. But really, that's the extent of my complaints on this thing. What matters the most at the end of the day is that there's just a lot of great pop songs on this album that are creatively produced, well performed, well written. I also love that the album feels very satisfying, yet also no bullshit and rounds out at a very modest 37 minutes. So while not a perfect album or a record that I see as going above and beyond, this is easily gonna be one of my favorite pop releases of the year. I'm feeling a decent 2 strong 8 on this thing. Tran, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Just leave a thoughtful comment in the comments. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that upworthy link to subscribe to the channel. US Girls, Poem Unlimited, forever.